A very good morning, my dear students. So we are doing data handling. What is data? Data is nothing but the information. Correct? Now this information could be qualitative as well as quantitative. Now what do you mean by qualitative? Qualitative means information on attributes like wisdom, intelligence, etc. But quantitative means the numbers. We deal with the numbers. For example, in class 8, how many students got more than 90%? Okay, or the height of the students above 165 centimeter or below 165 centimeter, etc. So such figures are called quantitative. When we deal with numbers, it becomes quantitative, and attributes that becomes qualitative. We are basically dealing with the quantitative information, that is numerical information. Correct? Now we have already started exercise 5.2. Today we'll be doing exercise same exercise 5.2, question number 2. Okay, the very first question is, the question number 2 is, there are given shoppers, kind of shoppers, so we have to arrange them. How many shoppers are there? We have to arrange them, and then we have to represent these shoppers with the help of bar graph. Okay, now before going to bar graph, let me tell you difference between bar graph and histogram. Now what is bar graph and histogram? When the rectangles, suppose this is a graph, suppose you have a line like this, this is called histogram. Now what is bar? As the name suggests, bar, separate. Now if you see in this figure, there is no gap. Okay, there is no gap, but in bar graph, gap is there. See, there is a gap. Here there is a gap is there. So we have to do question number 2 by this way, by drawing the bar graph. The very first thing we'll do is we'll make the table. That is called frequency distribution table. Frequency distribution table for shoppers or of shoppers, you can say. This heading is very important. Now we will write the heading as kind of shoppers. Then comes the remark. Then comes frequency. Kind of shoppers, telemark, then frequency. Now these shoppers are like W, M, B, G. W, M, B, G. Okay, now how many W's are there? There are 28 W's. There are 28 W's. So what we will do, we will start telling this. The first W, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. For every fifth shopper, we'll give a cut. Remember, I'm just talking about W. It only belongs to W. The shopper W. Okay, so this is 5. 5 plus 5, 10. Again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8. Again, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 25 plus 3, 28. So, we have 28 shoppers. You can see from the book. It will be easy for you. Clear? So, W, there are 28. There are 28 W's are there. And how this has come? 1, 2, 3, 4. For the fifth W, you give a cut. Again, go for the next one. 6, 7, 8, 9. 10th, you give a cut. 11, 12, 13, 14. For 15, you give a cut. For every 5, you have to give a cut. So there, you will find number of W's are 28. Similarly, you will find number of M's are 15. And number of B are 5. And number of G are 12. Okay, so these are the shoppers. So, and this 20, there are 28 W shoppers, there are 15 M shoppers, there are 5 B shoppers, and there are 12 G shoppers. So, this is called frequency. Telling marks, I hope you've understood. Now, if it is 15, how will you do this? This must be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. First you have to do this, remember. First you have to do this, then you have to come to this. Don't do this one directly. First you do this, then you do this. Okay? Is this clear? So in this way you have to make the table. Now how to draw the graph of this? That is bar graph. So I'll have to rub this now. This is W, this was M, this was B, and this was G. Or if you make it a little more this side, better. This is W, this is M, this is B, and this is G. Now see here, I have arranged this, there are 4 shoppers are there, one is W, then M, then B, then G, and there is a gap here, gap, because we are doing bar graph. In bar graph, we need to make the, we need to have graph, gap. So, now the first one W was 28, if you remember, the 28 is still here, so we will draw a line till 28. Then shade it. Shading is not necessary, but if you shade it, it looks better. It looks nice. It looks distinct. Okay, it looks, it becomes more attractive and more, you know, the pictures are very clear. Then comes M, that is 15. 15 is still, this is 16, 14, this is 16, this is 14. Naturally, the 15 will be lying in the middle of 14 and 16. So this is N. After that you have B. B is 5. So 5 again will lie between 6 and 4. So here it is. Then we have G. G is 12. So 12 is here. It is the, already we have the number here 12. Here. So all this you can sheet. Now this is the bar graph. Now the very important thing what you have to remember is, see, I have not started with, this is 0, but I have not started with 1. Because 28 is a big number, and if I write, if I start from 1, 2, 3, 4, this thing will not fit. The numbers will not fit here. So therefore I started with 2, 4, 6, 8, like that I have started. You can start with 1 also if you have a bigger graph paper. But if you have a smaller graph paper, then I would suggest you go with a higher number. Like for example, I started with 2. Take each box as a 2 or maybe 5, 10 or maybe 3, 6, like that. If you start with 1, you may have problems. Okay? So it depends on the graph paper also. So like for example, my board is was a little small. So therefore, I started with 2. So this is what this bar graph is all about. And one more thing, very important, you have to give the heading also that this bar graph is of what? This bar graph is of shoppers. Of shoppers. Okay, this bar graph is of shoppers. So this is how we make the bar graph. Clear? Remember, this scaling is very important. Always remember this. If you have taken one big box as 2 unit, you write here one big box is equal to 2 units. That was x-axis. I mean y-axis, sorry. Y-axis. Y-axis. So one big box we took as 2 units. Clear? So this is what is all about the bar graph. Today we'll do only one question. First you understand this, then we'll go for the histogram and then pie chart. Clear? So please go through this question. It's not difficult. I think you'll find it very easy. Again, if you have problem with the tally marks and frequency, do let me know. Again, I will teach you. Okay, so that's all for today. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.